Hello class, welcome once again to another tutorial. We have been dealing with most of these now, and we've started with the animation dash coffee. If this is your first tutorial to watch with us, understand that we've got other tutorials. We've got animation dash coffee, we have animation button or dash button, and we also have, this is still in Zoom, can take it back around 110, animation dash coffee, animation button. Now we are going to look at animation dash water. So you can check out our YouTube to see how you can also create something like this. You can add colors to this theme or to the cup. Like this could have a different color. This can have a different color. This can have a different color also. This could have a word like mom or dad or love or God or whatever thing else you would want. We'll insert a picture, make a picture and put it here on this cup. There are many other things you could do to this cup. The same applies to this animation button. There are quite a lot you could do to it. You could, for example, want to color the word. You could want to design this button differently. This is a full-fledged button that would open the site at skycodes.com. Many things, probably change the background or whatever you want to do with this, or simply call it a submit button or a login button, for example. Okay, so you can say I want to make this transition and the animation to be my login button. You change the word, call it login, and you will have your code working all like that. I've actually gotten that idea right now. I think it would be good to change it so my login to look like something like that. But usually we do not over design logins because they have just that small purpose, and then you move on. So today we are going to look at how we can create sort of a water animation using HTML and CSS. Right away we can have a wrapper, call it a container. And what that does is to have our h2, for example, we can say water. We can have another h2 here that says the same word. This is all you need for HTML, and then the rest will be playing around with just CSS properties. You could import if you wanted, but can import a font if you wanted, or you can just use the native ones that sit with HTML and CSS. We can say that the font family here is sans serif. We say that the margin is 0, padding is also 0. Box dash sizing, I am not explaining these because right now, by the time you reach here, these are not new concepts. If you are finding these new, please check our tutorials of margin, padding and borders and box sizing. You will understand why we are using them and why we are like that. So anything on the border, we are still using flexbox. If you are not familiar with flexbox, you can also check out our tutorial about flexbox. Actually, I would advise that someone studies flexbox before watching some of these tutorials, because if they are being designed with flexbox in mind, then it becomes a bit hard if you do not understand it. So once again, all these are normal properties. Most of these will be normal properties. There is nothing much you will be seeing that is new. Where it is new, we shall be explaining it. So is going to be 0, too bad, 0, comma 0, comma 0.8. Can cross this out, and now we are setting the background to look like that. We can pick it up here to see how it looks like. With a live server, we can go right now to Wrapper. Can go to Wrapper here and say position relative. At one point, we shall refer to it to set others to position absolute. We could then say that wrapper, the class h2, trying to increase specificity, otherwise h2 alone would pick it, but because you never know, you would want to add certain things that would also have h2, then we can specifically put this h2 under its own, so we have something like this, its own class. So position Ikre is absurd. The font size, we can increase it to 12 em. By now you should be able to know what 1 em represents. That is quite huge. We could change it to say 8. Okay. Can first and foremost center it by saying transform translate negative 50 on the x-axis, and also move negative 50%, so on the y-axis. Alternatively, we would also say top 50%, left 50%, and then we do this to make sure we are picking both sides correctly. So now we can position our element centrally here using transform property, transform translate. I will, with the position absolute, we always position it here centrally, from the top to the bottom, to the left, to the right, it will be at the center. So you can go ahead and say that dot wrapper h2. You remember we have two h2s, so nth child 1 is the first h2. Nth child 1 is the first h2, so we want to select exactly, we want to work on the first h2. That's what we are calling out now. Color is transparent. Remember, when we set these ones here, let me go back a little bit. Our tutorials are usually not about time, but making sure you understand the concept. That is why we are not rushing so much to finish under 10 minutes or 5 or 3, because it is important to understand why we use these parameters. That way you can also run on your own. So we set this h2, so both of them are on top of each other. We didn't use z index. If we apply the z index here, then we would separate them. Okay, the one with the higher z index would go on top. If we colored them differently, we would see that. There is no argument about that. If you do not know what we are talking about, you can check on our channel here. You can search about Z index still on our channel. You'll find amazing and beautiful examples. Now, color transparent, meaning the first one is given a transparent color even when you don't see a change here, because at the end of the day they were two, so they are inside each other. Then there is a webkit we can use, webkit -text. called dash text stroke. Not very common, but also important. You can say 3 pixels, and the color here that we want is just sky blue, to have some sort of something that would look like water. Now you see, okay, this is what we have for the first one. Now we can pick the same thing here and change it to, I hope you're able to see this, can expand it, zoom a little bit. Now we can change this to the 2, but instead of making the color transparent, the same color we have used here is what we use. So we shall have, we can pick this now because we don't need it. We are creating an outline here of 3 pixels and sky blue. But now we are saying we had not set any color for these H2s, but we are saying for the second H2, create that color. Now, this is what we have. Okay? So, once again, we are saying that the animation, because it is the animation that will play out these things, the animation name is water, the duration is say 5 seconds. For this is in out as a timing function, and then infinite as an iteration count, either number of seconds, but infinite we are saying play this forever. Okay, you would also, if you wanted, you for other things you can use, check the mount under transitions, you would study more about this. So now we can begin playing this. We can say at keyframes, okay, identifier would be water, that is the name of the animation, and then we say 0%. Now we can say 0%, 100%. Why? Because the animation at 0% and 100%, that is at the start and the end, we want it to look like the same, or to be the same. So that is how you set it. Instead of using the same parameters, 0 here, give it parameters, say maybe 50 in between different parameters, then 100%, the same parameters as the start parameters. You can use a comma to specify it quickly. But now, we have to use what we call polygons, and there is a nice page we can get our numbers from. It is here. You can just type in clip-path and hit enter without the word polygon, and it will bring you to this site. Click on Bennett, you will come to this site, and we want to have a custom. These are polygons you can use. A message polygon, so you would come, click on this, take this, and then, or even here, you would maybe want to specify how sharp it looks like, okay? Maybe that, and if that is what you want, then you would copy, you can increase this, maybe, to look something like this. It doesn't really matter. So it is up to you. That it is important you have all these certain points touching, especially the start and the end. So, but that is not what we want. All we want is to customize our own polygon. Okay, it is down here, so we can click on custom polygon. Then we have got points. We don't have to use many points. We can just use around 9 points. We are starting here, trying to create some sort of a wave. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Those are 2, 7, right, 8. Just this. It is not what I wanted, but you are getting the idea. Let me finish up. I click on this And then finally, when I come here, there is a tick. I can check it out like that. So I am able to copy this and paste it in my work. But I want to use something different once again. Add points. I have one here. Two. Create a path like this. Four. Move a little bit here. Five. Move a little bit here. Six. Move a little bit here. Maybe like this. Maybe here to seven. Then like this. Eight. This would be nine. This would be 10, and then this would be your end. So what you do, you can copy this and paste it in your work, or you can, after clicking on this, now you have an opportunity to see whether it is creating the wave you wanted. Okay, you can play around with these artists. I'm sure would do this better than us, so that it doesn't look very sharp like that. Maybe like that, something like this, hopefully. So all you have to do is copy this, okay, create path polygon, and then you copy this, and now you can paste it here as your starting path. So I can come, since this is customizable, I would want that to be 0%. I can make this say 15, and this is my 44, trying to recreate what I exactly would want. This can be say 32, and you can leave that at 51, no problem. Can make this 54 by 60, because now the shape would be seen when we play the animation. This is what we have, okay. So I'm approaching here, I am looking at what I want to create, something that goes like this. So every time I change properties here, that is what I will be changing. So you can paste them here. If they are not doing what you want, you keep on playing around these points, because it would also move with those points at 84, 59. That is 100. I want that at 52. When I go back, you can see now what I have. This I want to move up once again. I want this at 100, and also this at 0 finally, and 100. So this is what I have going down like this. We could create another one. You can come and say, because that is now end and start, how about in between, which is 50%. What do we have? You go back, follow the same procedure. So we can come back here and recreate another one for 50% custom here. We can say that maybe this is going to be like this once again, and moves like this, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Sorry, let me repeat that. art is not my thing. That is why I prefer codes, because holding a pencil to design is also not easy. To those who are able to use a pencil, good luck. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Could put a 6 here, then 7, 8, and 9, and then I finish it off here. So I am able to arrange it. This needs to sit at the end here. This one also needs to sit at the end, such that you can see 100 here. The start is not at the start, it should have been 0. So maybe this is the curve I want. Let us first look at what this gives us. Copy. We come to our 50% here. We paste the value. The thing should now be dancing. So that is the dance we have. If that is okay with you, no problem. You can leave it at that, and that would be your animation created. But we can tweak these values a little bit. I can create a different one. At 14, increase this to 17, make this say 49, 37 would be okay, 58, you can leave that at that, you can leave that at that, 74, 42, you can leave that at that. And make this to be slightly that, 100. So we can now see what we have created. You can see it here. Now it is slightly better than what we had. But you've known how to pick these paths for polygons, and this is okay. This can be red. You don't have to feel like you were cheating, because even when you are dealing with other programming languages, you would need, for example, button designers for Java, and then you pick the image of a well-designed button and use it in your code. So that is important, and I would like to say thank you for enabling us. Leave, you can like, subscribe, and share this information such that people can actually get to know that these things exist.